Triangle harps started appearing around the 9th century, and by the 11th and 12th century had pretty much replaced the lyre-type instruments almost entirely. They started off relatively small, only having about maybe 15 or 17 strings, and they got bigger throughout the Middle Ages and into the Renaissance. So by the late Renaissance and the Baroque period, they were large floor harps, almost like you would see now. This particular instrument is a kind of harp called a Bray harp. This style dates from about the 13th or 14th century. The strings, again, are made out of gut. Metal strings only existed on the Irish and Gaelic harps. And they were played with the fingernails rather than with the pads of the fingers. They had a much more ringing bell-like sound. These instruments have a surprising sound. They actually have little pins that are right at the base of each one of those strings. It's a little L-shaped pin, and it brushes against the base of the string. And what that does is it causes it to have a snarling, almost buzzy sound. That's not quite what we would expect from a harp. We tend to think of a harp as having a kind of a lush, laborious sound. These have a more twangy sound, which was the preferred aesthetic of the Middle Ages. It also carries a little bit more with the small size of the harp. It has a much more sharp sound that will carry in a larger open space. The song that I'm going to be playing for you is called Je n'en ai pris. It was written by Richard Lionheart, the King of England, while he was languishing away in prison. After having returned from the Crusades, he was captured by a German nobleman who held him for ransom from the English. While he was languishing away in the tower, he wrote this song, more or less complaining about how everyone's forgotten him and how he's basically languishing away in solitude, which I'm sure everybody can experience right now as a very common thing that everyone is dealing with. The song was heard supposedly by a famous troubadour by the name of Blondel de Delay, who heard Richard singing it in the tower and started spreading it amongst the nobles of Aquitaine in England to shame them into raising up this ransom to free Richard, which they eventually did. So the second piece that I'm doing is actually by Blondel de Delay, and it's just one of his little short chansons.